Hey everybody, it's me, ShadowBlazer3000 here. My voice sounds a little, not so good. You probably saw my unboxing. I'm kind of getting over a bit of a cold or flu or something of that variety. Took a couple days off work to hopefully recuperate so that I can be back next time I work. And, well, my voice is getting a little better. But that's not important right now. That's not what you're here about. You're here to hear me talk about Erased, or Boku Dake Inaimachi. I know I'm a couple days late, but that's because my voice was shot on Thursday. I could barely speak. And I had just gotten off a long shift, and I had been coughing all day, and yeah, it wasn't pleasant. But now I have a bit more of a voice. I'm a little congested, but I think I'll be able to manage through this. And now I'm here to talk about the new episode, and, well, here we are, in this new episode. Where are we? Four now? I think so. And unfortunately, our worst fears have been realized. Satoru has failed. He failed to save Kaio. He couldn't save her life. And unfortunately, this has made some new twists on the story here. And that's the interesting part, is now there's a whole new set of circumstances going on, and let me get into the episode details here. Unfortunately, as I said, Satoru has realized he's failed. The teachers have all put up a front that Kaio has simply left home to go live with a grandmother, but it's all just a ruse to not panic or scare the kids. I think that's kind of bullshit, but whatever. But not only has Satoru failed in his mission to save Kaio, nothing else has changed. The other kids still go missing too. And the teachers all keep giving the same ruse to the students, that these students have all simply just left home. And now, of course, Satoru feels awful that he failed. And he blames himself, essentially, that he couldn't save her. He did everything he possibly could, but the future refused to change. Pardon the Chrono Trigger joke. And so one day, Satoru is walking, he decides to go near Kaio's home, and he sees Kaio's mother, whom at this point we have all known to be a horrible person, just in a garbage bag. And this was kind of a creepy scene, by the way, because I really thought, oh god, he's gonna find her body in that garbage bag. Her mother throws out a garbage bag, and it turns out that it's got her mittens, or the mittens she made for Satoru, I'm not really sure which. And he freaks out, of course, and he decides to run away, and then he goes back to the present. We could tell that this is going to be a time reset, right? But now he's gone back to the present, or back to the future, or whatever, he's gone through time travel, right? Time travel, it's confusing. And now that he's gone back, but nothing's changed, essentially. His mother's still murdered. He still has the blood on his hands. He's still a suspect of interest. So now what does he do? He failed in the past, but now he's got to try and remedy in the present, it seems like. And now here's where the tone of the story is changing. And not for bad or anything, but it's interesting to see how this tone is now starting to change. For the first sort of three episodes actually, we've had a lot more dramatic suspense. Now we're moving into a realm of dramatic thriller, because now there's some new twists and some new revelations. And I guess I should also back up here, because I kind of skipped over a detail. As to what's happened to Kaio, for all we know at this point, we've always assumed that she was abducted and murdered. But from at this point, we now see that it's pretty clear that her mother and whoever the guy is that lives with her mother, it's probably a boyfriend, seem to be responsible. So my guess is they beat her to death, which is awful. It's absolutely fucking awful. And so naturally they're trying to cover it up. They don't want to be held responsible. And the abductions are just sort of a convenient ploy to sort of get away with it. Sorry, I'm losing my train of thought here, I guess. But it's a convenient ploy that they can kind of hide behind is that the fact these other children have gone missing. So the abductions are still happening, and Kaio has still been killed. But this leads me to question now. Was Kaio always abducted, or has Satoru's presence in the past changed things? This is where we get into time travel craziness here. Because it's like, was Kaio just beaten to death? Is that always the case, or was she actually abducted? We'd always assume she'd been abducted. But now it's pretty obvious, now she was beaten to death, or something else has happened to her. Something has happened to cause Kaio to be killed, and her mother and probably boyfriend to freak out and stash the body somewhere. And now that we're back in the present, we're back in the future where Satoru has left off. If you recall, and I might have forgotten to mention her, but if you recall the co-worker from episode 1, Satoru's co-worker at the pizza joint, this girl, Irie. Well, she believes Satoru. She believes he's innocent, and this kind of goes back into her own history with her family, and I guess her father was accused of shoplifting, and it unfortunately just kind of caused her parents to split up. I know it seems kind of petty, but people do fight and break up over stupid shit like that, so I can't say I cannot believe it. It really makes sense that something is outlandish as a shoplifting accusation could lead to a series of unfortunate events within a family. And Irie wants to shelter Satoru. She wants to aid and abet him, which obviously is a criminal act, but she doesn't care. She wants to help him. But here's where things are starting to get really weird and interesting again. Satoru's manager, at first we just assume it. He's just trying to cover his own ass and turn Satoru over to the police, because he does try to turn Satoru in. But now we see that the manager seems to be in the pockets, or lining the pockets of what seems to be a local politician. We don't know who this man is. We don't know his connection to anything yet, but there's something suspicious here. There's so many layers to this mystery, I'm enjoying it. Oh, this is so good. I can't help it, I'm fangasming here. I'm gushing because there's so many layers to this mystery. This is a really, really intricate and deeply woven mystery, because there's one more piece to this puzzle. Now, and that is this shady politician now. I'm pretty sure it's a politician because he mentions like council, you know, city council, and he's giving kickbacks and... Right, and you might think this wouldn't be an issue, but... And it may not be. It could be another red herring. We've had a lot of red herrings in this series to throw us off. But it's pretty apparent that this guy is suspicious and he's up to no good because, well, creepy, ominous music, but again, could be a red herring. He's faceless, which usually indicates that there's something to hide about this character. And he was suspiciously eyeing Irie as she was leaving. So it seems like this man might be involved somehow, but why? Why is this shady politician of all people involved in the... You know, how does he connect to the abductions? How does he connect to Kaio's death? How does he connect to Satoru's framing of his mother's death? How does this all connect? That's what we're going to have to wait and see now with the next several episodes. As Satoru is now going to have to try and once again solved the mystery. But now he can't save the... He couldn't save Kaio. He couldn't save his mom. But he's got to save himself now. And now Airi is a target. Because at the very end of this episode, cliffhanger ending here, Airi's house, or it's the house she's living in with her, I guess, her uncle and aunt, and the house she's in is set on fire and she's trapped, because unfortunately, I have to kind of say, this is a too dumb to live moment because you fail fire safety for forever, because it's like, they teach you, first thing they teach you in fire safety, feel the door when you start smelling smoke. And she just opens the door. I'm sorry, I shouldn't be making light of it. It's an intense situation, but it's like at the same time, it's like, come on, that's fire safety 101. You fail. You've got to deserve to die. I'm kidding. I don't think Airi deserves to die. She's fine. I want her to live. I hope she lives, but I hoped Kaio would live. We were all just hoping this would be a fake out. Not a fake out. Damn it. So that's episode 4 in a quick nutshell. As I said, it's really interesting to see how the tone is now changing from dramatic mystery and suspense to dramatic thriller. And that's not a bad thing, because it feels like that's a progression of plot. It feels like it's moving in that direction. We're getting the pieces are coming together to make the thrill. I love when a mystery does that. I love when the mystery... We start with the suspense, and then we end with the thrills. That's a good mystery to me. I mean, maybe some just prefer straight-line whodunit mystery and try to figure out the culprit. Fine. But to me, I love the mysteries that they start with a lot of suspense, a lot of questioning, they make you question everything, and then they start to show you the mystery. They start to fill in the answers for you if you haven't. And that's what I want. That's to me what I love about a good mystery, and this is a really good mystery show. So that pretty much quickly sums up Erased episode 4. I think it's 4. I should be a little more certain. So now we have a new angle on this mystery, the involvement of the manager and this mysterious politician, and we need to see how does it all connect. And that's what we're going to be able to hopefully find out in the next half of the show. Because now we're about entering the midway point. This is a 12-episode show. So 6 episodes. We're going to be halfway through the series. Excellent show. I'm enjoying it. I can't help but gush about it. It's one of the... This might be the only show I ever do this weekly vlog on now. Because I enjoy... talking about it so much, and because unfortunately this is the only way I can talk about it with avoiding any major spoilers down the road. So once again, if you've read the manga, please refrain from spoiling. Don't even drop hints, okay? I want the immersion and I want the suspense that the anime is giving me. And you people, and for the most part, I think you people have been fine. You manga readers have been fine. They've been courteous and not spoiling. Or, that, you know, they mark their spoilers where needed. So I'm very careful in avoiding a lot of the discussion forums at, like, my anime list so that I don't stumble upon spoilers. So guys, thanks for joining me. I'm ShadowBlazer3000. I will see you tonight, hopefully, on Geek News Reviews and Opinions. I should be on the show tonight. My voice is doing better and I'm able to talk again. And... if you don't catch us tonight live, well, hopefully you catch the episode later. Thanks for joining me.